Hello everyone, welcome to Capsule Academy. This is Leo. Today we're going to learn new concept English Book 2, Lesson 44, Practices. 那注意，进行如下所有练习，唯一的前提就是文章要跟读至熟读成诵啊，否则请勿开始。Hope you guys enjoy it. Okay, 那我们先看这个第一个题叫 comprehension, 对吧？听懂一般疑问句和特殊疑问句的能力。我问，您答。来了。Who ran through a forest after two men? Mrs. Anne Sterling. Next one. What didn't she think of as she ran? Of the risk she was taking.Next one. Was she with her children? Yes, she was. Next one. What were they doing? Having a picnic. Next one. Where were they having their picnic? At the edge of a forest. Next one. Had the two men rushed up to her? Yes, they had.Next one. What did they try to steal? Her handbag. Next one. There was a struggle, wasn't there? Yes, there was. Next one. What broke in the struggle? The strap of her handbag. Next one. Where did they both start running?Through the trees. Next one. Did she run after the two men? Yes, she did. Next one. She was soon out of breath, wasn't she? Yes, she was. Next one. She caught up with them, didn't she? Yes, she did. 好, asking questions.
练习的是我们会说一般疑问句和特殊疑问句的能力，也就是我们发问的能力，对吧？在现实生活当中这个实际应用上啊。OK, 我们先看个例子，叫做 Mrs. Anne Sterling was having a picnic. Was 提前就可以了，然后 who, 那对主语提问直接替代，对吧？叫 who was having a picnic. 好，我们接下来挨个对啊。首先 where, 这里没有 where,就是直接加整句，叫 Where was Mrs. Anne Sterling having a picnic? 看见了哈，就跟 why 一样，直接加在整句话的最开始就可以了。Next one, 说 She was with her children. Was 往前一提，那 who 点点 with, 啊，你加谁都行，我觉得啊，你可以对 her children 叫 Who was she with, 对吧 ？OK, 也可以说 Who was with her children.So they were sitting at the edge of a forest, were 往前提 ,where, 对 ,at the edge of a forest 提问 ,why 加整句 ,who 对主语提问。Two men rushed up to her, 这里肯定是 did 提前动词换原形对吧 ?How many, 对 to 提问对不对 ?How many men rushed up to her? Next one, 说 they tried to steal her handbag, did 提前对不对然后 what?对 her handbag 提问吧对吧他们尝试偷什么其实是抢我在文章那一刻说了啊那个视频。第六个说 the strap broke in the struggle, did 提前对吧然后换回原形那 what 对 the strap 提问所以注意对主语提问不用变一般疑问句答案直接就是 what broke in the struggle, OK? Next one, 说 the man ran off with a bag,did 往前提然后 what 对 the bag 对吧 OK They start running through the trees did 往前提然后 where 对 through the trees 外加整句 who 对 they 提问、啊、不用变一般疑问句答案叫 who started running through the trees Next one Mrs. Sterling was very angry was 往前提 why 整句话 who对 Mrs. Sterling 提问对吧这个 why 对整句话是整个一般疑问句提问啊。She ran after them, did 往前提 ,what 点点 do 就是标准答案 ,what did she do, 是吧她做了什么 ?She was soon out of breath, was 往前提 ,why 加整句话叫 why was she soon out of breath, 啊。好 ，tell the story， 这是我们练习口语复述的能力啊，这在实际应用英文当中非常重要，更多练的是我们 fluency 啊，练的是我们这个说话的流利性。所以文章在熟读成诵之后，你这里啊，在复述的时候可以错一点点，但不能怎么样，听好，但不能不流利啊，就是一定要快一点点，好吧？好，summer writing 这样的写作，写作复述能力，这对于我们应试考试也好，比如说国内的考试、国外的雅思托福考试，又或是工作当中的实际应用，这个能力都非常的重要啊。好，这是答案，写完了，这是对答案就行了，我们不多说了。然后 topic for discussion 就是我们所有练习到最后其实目的就是能做到这样的事儿，就是我说的又流利然后又准确，对吧？就跟我母语一样，就一个话题我就能聊起来，对不对？然后你比如说这里说 What do you think were the contents of Mrs. Sterling's handbag? 你认为她这包里有什么东西？ What sort of things do you usually carry around in your handbag pocket? Why? 你兜里平常都装什么？为啥？Do you like going on picnics? 你喜欢出去野餐吗？ What sort of place do you choose? Why? 你会选择什么样的地方？为什么？ In what kinds of situation do ordinary people suddenly behave in an extraordinary way? 说在什么样的，在哪些情况之下，普通人会突然间表现得非常的不普通。啊，你比如说我们说妈妈突然间看到孩子从高空掉下来，会以百米冲刺的速度跑过去，这就叫 ordinary people suddenly behave in an extraordinary way. OK， 好，那不多说了，加上作业 ，ask me if， 先写，写完了之后大声朗读，摘要写作先写，然后对答案 ，tell the story 进行口语复述，专栏当中您都能找得到，好吧？然后呢，以上就是本期视频的全部内容了。如果各位喜欢我们的课程呢，欢迎各位关注订阅一键三连，分享给那些需要的朋友，来帮助我们快速成长。 See you next time.